Since I got more than 10 views from my last video, I decided to continue entertaining you.
Oh, no.
You have monotone, sir.
Some parts of the video have poor audio.
Obviously, reading some scripts.
Alright, now let's enjoy the clips of famous young singers. Justin Bieber started his career at the age of 13 in his first famous and hated song, Baby.
Oh, the land of the free.
Taylor Swift, at the age of 10 years old, developed hit songs that reference to her breakups.
No one can face me like a lady breaks me.
Britney Spears started at the age of 11 that has songs telling you to hit her one more time. Miley Cyrus at the age of 11. This girl is the perfect description of a girl that evolved so much in backwards. Rihanna started at 15, had the best songs you ever hear, and literally took the song of Britney Spears in the face.
Baby, one more time.
Oh my god! Wow!
You at the back, you're asking me, why am I showing some footage of kids singing? Well, the point is, what they had in common are very good in singing, obviously. Had some episodes as they grew up, and they all started very young in the vast world of entertainment and still remain successful. I will be introducing this wonderful person who shocks and put a smile to our American allies. This boy or girl is a singer, which is the pride of every Filipino.
Yes, I would die for your baby, but you won't do the same.
No, he's good, but not that.
Work hard, play hard, hot chicks on my radar. Stay lit on that liquid till we black out like Darth Vader. Squad it up with these hot bays and they stay south of the equator. I shine like a quasar, ain't another nigga crazier.
Fancy dance move and rapping, but not that one. I remember her, but not that one.
Panako para sa Pilipino.
No, not that one also. He or she is Charisse Pengpengko. I have a story to tell you. Imagine I am Jake Zayas.
Ng Pilipino, iwagayway, ibang klase ang talino. Idol!
See that guy drinking cheap rum? Yup, that's me. You're probably wondering how I end up in this situation.
What we do here is go back.
Like, as far as I know, the first time she went, like, viral is when she went to Korea and shook our Korean friends with her version of a classic Whitney Houston. That progress, obviously she was invited to a Karen show.
Love you.
Thank you.
Bruh. Thank you again.
After that, she appeared on the Oprah show and she showcased her singing ability. And guess what? The second time she appeared in Oprah, she was surprised by Oprah to sing in a Celine Dion concert. A fucking Celine Dion concert in a very young age, nailing every notes, nailing every singing. In a foreign country of America, let that sink into you. With that, she became the producer of David Foster. As you all kids don't know, she is a very talented guy. Everything about music, from letter M to letter C, he knows how to polish and make it a masterpiece. And responsible for nurturing talented artists like Christina Aguilera, Air Supply, Andrea Bocelli, Toni Braxton, Michael Bublé, Mariah Carey, Natalie Cole, Alice Cooper, Celine Dion, Kenny G, Josh Groban, Whitney Houston, Michael Jackson, and our very own Jake
Charisse Pimpenko
Zyrus.
It's a fireplace. Guide us with your grace. Give us faith so we'll be saved.
duets with Andrea Bocelli, which sings our go-to song every time we start our religious program in our school. I remember this one, that David was so impressed with Cherie's contented talent that he almost wanted to adopt Cherie. I guess we can all safely say that he could become a foster parent. With this kind of producer, she drops her first song, which obviously not affiliated with any kind of conspiracy and not stigmatize singers or artists who are affiliated with Illuminati. She released a song called Pyramid.
There'll never be another love for sure. Ayaza Jaris, let we go.
Stones, heavy like the love you shot.
I remember this song, which was very fine and very catchy. This song actually broke a record for the first solo Asian singer on the Billboard chart in top 10 for a couple of weeks. She has more catchy songs like Louder, One Day, and Before Explodes, composed by our comrade Bruno Mars. She also appeared in Glee, a high school musical that has drama and comedy in it. It's like a TV show, which I didn't actually watch it, but as far as I know, when you are a member of a Glee or thinking of joining the Glee Club, you will have the right to sing any song you like in any part of the school you like to sing it. She played as Sunshine Corazon, a Filipino who is very shy, nerdy, but talented, and for some reason assumed dumb in speaking in English.
You like me sing very much.
How do you like me to respond, Lyle Mitchell? Yes, you good and singing. Well, to be honest, everything being portrayed are actually true when we are drunk.
Shot.
No. I don't drink.
No. One drink only.
Okay. Thank you. Bro, every time we speak on this particular hour, particular minute, particular second, the universe is expanding.
Tonight, the end is near. I saw a face of a firebird. Did it my way.
Speaking of TV series, she had a cameo in a movie, Alvin and the Chipmunks 2.
Son of Alvin yet, huh?
And had an actual movie on Here Comes the Boom with Kevin James, which obviously she is a student of Kevin James that tried mixed martial arts to gain money to save the closure of the school music program. And she also teach the legend Baz Rutten, which is an immigrant, on how to memorize the U.S. history through singing.
Right. Okay.
America, as a president.
Yes.
He serves
a 4-year term.
He serves a 4-year term before he's done.
Nice.
Uh-huh. Also hypens up Kevin James before the big fight as she sings Holly Holy.
Come here. You're not gonna believe this.
I guess these are all the highlights I could see from her early life, and I believe we could all agree she is a legend. She came out in 2013 and she announced that she is a lesbian.
That's it, I'm gay. Like,
that's how Filipino react. And maybe some fans and maybe some future or present endorsement. Instead of being happy for him, we all bury how talented he is and focus so much in gender. But before anything else, like any teenager blessed with fame, No. I could say with this timeline, he was bombarded with fame. Obviously, she was guided by adults. Let's not be blind, because these are the legit symptoms of famous teenagers. Like they always say, with great fame comes great haters. I remember people are calling him fat, ugly, why you did this to your hair, why are you staying so much in America, you want to be an American, or you stay so much in America, why are your skin still brown, did you forget being a Filipino? Which, by the way, I believe Charisse possibly reads some of these comments. On top of that, his father died. No, his father was killed.
Mosher, when I went to the funeral, I saw him right there and regretted everything that I wish I could have.
Because when was the last time you had seen or talked to him?
It was like 17 years ago. And so,
wow. You
know, I took all those feelings, I took all the pain in me and made me stronger.
His father was killed in the middle of his rising fame at a young age. You are missing a piece of puzzle to share your found success. That gives tremendous pressure that would cause anxiety or depression. With all of that, he lied with a smile and being happy and not being tired. And that one time, he was being honest about his feelings and revealing his true self, we all turn him down.
Why are you gay?
Who says I'm gay?
You are gay.
Instead of asking, why are you gay? We skip everything and just be happy for him. Simple as that. Even Oprah is happy for him.
One of the things I love most about Charisse is that no matter what obstacles she's faced in her life, she's never given up on her dream of something better. So why?
Even this Korean guy who foresees it and still happy for Jake Stalin.
This is fantastic, not you. You're so fantastic,
yo,
you know.
Man. Thank you, man, my brother.
Bruh.
Your sister.
Yo, man. Yo.
He doesn't look for his gender or what his gender would be. He's just happy for the talent and being impressed. When you all have this fame at the young age, sir, the sad music, please? When you have all this fame at a young age, it always rhymes with pain. Pain from unknown future, pain from people you trust the most, doesn't believe in you. Pain from sudden loss of a loved one, or pain from people you want to please but doesn't appreciate you. Or since we really don't know Jake Cyrus personally, maybe fame rhymes with same. Since we are all the same human, we have the same feelings of happiness, loneliness, insecurities, and looking forward what's ahead of us. It also rhymes with aim, aiming for the betterment of oneself by stopping the hate for a girl, boy, gay, or transgender. It also rhymes with flame, the person who has the same flame since she started.
Yeah, I'm always dreaming that someday I can be a part of your show. Now, I can't believe I'm here standing in front of you.
Now you're here. Now you're here.
No, this is my dream come true.
Can't be extinguished by trials in life.
You see, no matter how hard I love singing, anxiety is taking over, and it's real. So if ever you have friends or daughter, son, cousin, even moms and dads, if you're feeling the anxiety, depression, it's very important to talk to someone.
Jake Cyrus is the best example of courage for facing trials, being true to self, and remain the same enthusiasm in singing. Instead of saying Jake should be like this, or Jake should go back like this, or Jake should stop doing this, has any one of you maggots asked just one time, how are you, Jake? No one, right? The same implies with people surrounding you, with your friends, your loved ones, or family. You are free to ask, how are you? Because if they don't have the same coping mechanism like Jake, despite all of the trials in life, I just don't know what will happen then.
They try to grow.